Hickory dickory dock. Ooh, time to beat the clock. Time for fun has now begun. Let's all play beat the clock.
Beat the Clock is brought to you by Sylvania. For half a century, a quality name in incandescent bulbs, fluorescent tubes and fixtures, photo lamps, radio and television sets, radio and television tubes and electronic devices. Yes, for homes, offices, schools and factories, Sylvania.
Let's all play Beat the Clock.
Now, here is America's number one clock watcher, Bud Cutter!
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to Beat the Clock. Surely you can have the time of your life playing against time for big time prizes. And thank you, Vern Bennett. Now, if you come over here with me, we'll meet our holdover contestants from last week. Hi there. Nice
Hello.
To see you again. How are you? Did you get a week to catch your breath a little bit, did you?
Just about, sir. Huh?
Not much breath catching.
Have you caught a seat? Now, last week you had gone through, as Mr. and Mrs. George Kern, you'd gone through the $100 clock, hadn't you?
Yes, we had.
You were just about to start the $200, didn't even get far enough to know what it was going to be. Uh-oh. We have a special surprise for you tonight, and a special surprise for everybody watching our show. So I want you to just sort of stand by and see what happens later on in the program. You'll be very much a part and parcel of it. Also, you or anyone else who was on our show tonight may be part and parcel of our new bonus stunt, which is tonight worth $200. Whenever the bell rings, the old bonus bell, you know, that's the one whoever happens to be the microphone at that time. But we'll find out now what your problem is on the $200 clock in just a second. Mr. and Mrs. George Kern, Flushing, New York, your $200 stunt involves only Mrs. Kern. So you can just stand by here, relax, and let her do the work. Matter of fact, it ties with some work. Will you be cooking the Christmas dinner for
yes,
your family?
Yes, I will.
Have a turkey?
Yes.
Well, how do you cook a turkey? Do you baste it?
No.
It's in the oven? You don't?
I cook it on its breast, and then you don't have to baste it.
Well, ours is not fixed that way. We have to have basting. So would you come over here with me? I'll show you. We have a special... Step right up on that little box there. I disappeared a minute, but here I am again. There we are. Now, there's our turkey, you see? And it's not being cooked breast down, it's breast up. And what we want you to do is to baste it for us, that's all. And the basting we have is some rather heavy gravy that is in this pitcher. Now, your problem is simply to pour it over that turkey until the turkey is well covered. That's all there is to it. You have a certain number of seconds. Madeline, would you take it around to her? And then I want you to take a hold of the pitcher, Mrs. Kern, and hold it out over the turkey so that you can gauge about how far you'd have to hold it to pour it on the turkey. Hold it over there now. Don't pour, but just see about, you get an idea of where you think. Would that about pour it on the turkey? Okay, the reason I ask you to do that is because what we're going to do now, rest your arm back there. You can rest this right on top here if you want to. We're going to ask you to take your hat off because we're going to blindfold you. See?
Oh.
That's it. Going to put a blindfold on you and then see whether or not in the number of seconds, now let's pull this down. Can you see anything at all?
No.
That's pretty dark in there, huh? Because what we're going to do is ask you to see how well you can baste the turkey. If you baste the turkey completely, why then you'll stop the clock and you'll beat the clock. And, I moved it. Oh, brother, I almost dropped the turkey here. That would never do. I want to shift around so it's right in the right spot for you. Okay. Now, you remember about when. I'll tell you this that I will do for you. I will constantly tell you either to the right, to the left, reach out a little further from you, or pull it back a little closer to you. Do you understand? Because if you get that turkey well basted, we'll stop the clock and you'll beat the clock. And I'll take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. You have 30 seconds to get it basted. Reach your arm out. Put your arm out over the turkey a little further. A little further. Let me take a look here. A little more to your left. A little more to your left. Right about there, I think. You ready? Go! That's fine. Good. Closer to you. Closer to you. Closer to you. That's it. All right. All right. That's fine. Yep. Doing fine. All right, give her another pitcher there. Here's another pitcher. This is one part of the turkey that isn't very well covered. There you are. Fresh one. A little more to the right. To the right. Now hold it. You keep waving it. Don't wave it. Now a little further out from you. That's fine. All right, stop the clock and take a look, and I think you'll agree with us that you've basted that turkey real well. Okay, Roxanne, come on out with one of your Sylvania blue dot flash bulbs. Take a picture of him for fun. Stay right there just a minute while Roxanne takes his picture, will you? There we are. We'll get that for you. And now, Miss Kern, you come on back over here with me, if you will. Can you get down all right? All right, swell. Not that we think your husband is a turkey, you understand, but we'll get him all cleaned up as good as new for you. He'll be returned to you just as though nothing ever happened to him. Say, are the kids here, Margie
and
Roger?
Yes, they are.
Oh, they're watching backstage,
yes.
Yeah? Bet they got a kick out of that one.
I'll bet they did. They were hoping for whipped cream, but that was better.
All they got was gravy. All right, well, now, here we go into your jackpot try, which is all yours to do. If you step back here and step up on the end of that little platform, right down to the very end, and face the audience, if you please, I'll tell you when to turn around. At back of you and back of this curtain is our magnetic board with all of the words of a famous saying or quotation all held there by magnetism. They're all out of order, however. You've got to unscramble them in 20 seconds from the time I say go so we can read the saying or quotation we're after. Do you understand? Right, now, don't look till I tell you to. Open the curtain. Turn around, take a look. Go. Stop the clock. Where there's a will, there's a way, and you had it and you did it. Came back, having gone through the $100 clock, you have now gone through our jackpot clock, so let's see what you've won. Just take a look over here.
Mr. and Mrs. Kern, your prize is Sylvania's exquisite console, the Montclair, with genuine hand-rubbed mahogany inlay doors. A large 21-inch movie-clear television with surrounding halo light for the greatest viewing comfort in all television. The Montclair is outstanding in performance and design. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Kern. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
My congratulations. Go back and find your husband. Oh, all right, Roxanne, who's our next contestant?
Bud, I'd like you to meet Mr. and Mrs. Donald Hess from Elizabethtown, Pennsylvania.
Thank you very much. AM2 Navy, is that right, Don?
That's right.
What does that mean, AM2?
Aviation Structural Mechanics.
Well, welcome to our show, sir. It's nice to have you. Is that you shaking or me?
I think it's... I won't answer.
How are you, Mrs. Hess? How long have you been married? 2.5 years, it
yes.
says here.
Almost.
And you have a little son?
Yes.
Where is he?
Well, he's home tonight.
Somebody's babysitting,
yes.
I hope. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, now, we're not going to waste any time. You live in Elizabethtown, Pennsylvania. And incidentally, I want to tell you that if you watch our show regularly, next week should be a lot of fun for you and all you folks watching, as a matter of fact. We sort of got an idea it might be fun to review the best stunts of 1952. Now, in other words, it's not going to be necessarily the best that we necessarily think so, but... the audience reaction, plus the reaction of the contestants who did them. We try to figure out where both sides of the equation had the most fun. These are going to constitute our show next week. Should be a lot of laughs involved for you. So if you have a minute, why, you be sure to watch, will you? Mr. and Mrs. Hess, we'll move you right along now into a little problem that involves your wife, Mr. Hess. May I borrow for just a minute?
Yes, sir.
Okay, come over here with me, Miss Hess, if you will. And I want to show you that here, thank you, Betty, we have a Venetian blind, you see? This is one of those with the metal slats, you know, that are quite flexible. You see that they'll separate quite wide there, you see. They'll go very wide. And I could, while separating those slats, stick a balloon in between them and leave it there. And the slats would close down tight enough on it to hold it. Now, that's all we want you to do, is to get two balloons stuck in between the slats. Maybe one on this side, maybe one on that side, any way you want, as long as there are two stuck in that blind without your holding them there. Do you understand?
Yes.
And that's all you have to do. Take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. You have 55 seconds for just two balloons, and Madeline or Betty will hand you the balloons. If you drop one, don't go chasing it. We'll give you another one, see? Well, are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Well, put your left hand behind your back. You can only use one hand. And you can't press it against your body and hold it there. It's got to be just your hand or your arm. You ready? Go! And they're getting kind of rough, and I'm not going to be unfair to you. I'll straighten them out a little bit. Now, let me give you one little clue. I thought you had it on the one, and that's this. Look, take a hold of this by that. Then you can just push your hand right through and leave it. Now, you've only got 15 seconds. Are you ready? Go. That's a girl. Be careful when you take your hand out. All right, stop the clock. Okay, Mrs. Brown. Venetian blinds, that's a way you can do it. It's not a way that's recommended, but it might be a lot of laughs for you on the way. All right, Mr. and Mrs. Hess, that got you through the $100 clock rather painlessly, and of course moves you up now, as fast like a bunny, up to the $200 clock. Now, where are you stationed right now, Don?
USS Bennington, Brooklyn Navy Yard.
I see. I suppose all your friends are watching?
I don't know, sir.
Well, they better keep their fingers crossed for you. We'll find out what your next problem. And Mrs. Hess, if you'll both come over here. And Don, I'm going to ask you to go right on past this, if you will, and take a position next to that table down there. See it? On the side of it that you're on. Now turn around and face us when you get there. That's it. Mrs. Hess, suppose you stand right about next to this one, and I'll show you that hanging between you is a long string attached to a little stick at the end. Now, if I were to swing that over to Don, he can catch it when it gets to him, see? And he can swing it right back to you. The only thing is, you're going to do just that, but you're not going to do it quite that way. When I say go, you're to quickly take up two cups, put them on the ends of that, comme ça, and then let that swing to Don. And if it gets there without any, either of the cups breaking, and he gets them both off and puts them on the table, swings it back to you, and you do the same with two more cups, we'll stop the clock and you'll beat the clock. Want four cups on that table unbroken. And he must get two cups at a time. In other words, if one falls off and he catches the other, that's no good. Got to start over. Get the idea? All right, four cups on that little thing over there, and we'll stop the clock and you'll beat it. Take a look and see how many seconds you have. 50 seconds. Are you ready? Go! Swing it over. Come on, you haven't got too much time. Okay, two you got without them breaking. Come on now, quick, get them on there, fast like a bunny. Here we go, let it go. Quick, hurry up, you haven't got too much time. Hey, got it right off the bat without any of them breaking. How about that? Good boy. Come on. Let me have that a minute, will you? Hey, whoa. Maybe I want to try that. I don't know why. I broke them all this afternoon. I don't know. What have you got in your hands? Anything? I don't know what.
Boy, oh.
You should see the crockery I broke trying that this afternoon. I did it, but only after great effort, believe me. All right, Mr. and Mrs. Hess, let's see now. You had the Indian sign on us on that. Let's hope you have it again, because now comes your turn to try for our jackpot clock. So if you'll step down over there, Don, you can't help in any way but holding good thoughts for Mrs. Hess, whom I'm going to ask to step up on the platform there, right near the end, and turn around and face the audience. Don't turn around toward the board until I tell you to. Face out that way, if you will. Back of this curtain is our jackpot board. All of the words of a famous saying or quotation, but they're all mixed up. You get them unmixed in 20 seconds from the time I say go. Do you understand? Okay, open the curtain. Take a look. Go. Seconds left. You don't know what, Miss Hess? Time's running out. Oh, golly, you almost got it. You're getting the idea. Strike while the iron is hot is what it should have been, Miss Hess. Strike while the iron is hot. Well, come on back in here, Don Hess, and stand alongside your wife because you've beaten our $200 clock. Let's see what you've won.
Mr. and Mrs. Hess, you have won two wonderful prizes. First, from the Michael C. Fina Company of New York City, six sterling silver play settings in the distinctive Chateau Rose pattern, all conveniently arranged in a tarnish-proof chest. And a wonderful Sew Gem sewing machine, which the Gelman Manufacturing Company, makers of Sew Gem, guarantee not to lock, clog, or jam while you're sewing. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Hess. You've just won Beat the Clock prizes worth more than $200.
Now, Roxanne.
But we have Mr. and Mrs. Richard McLean from Belmore, New York.
Hey, another pretty blonde like you here. How are you, Mrs. McLean? Nice to meet you. And Richard, or Dick, what do I call you, Dick?
Yes, okay, sir. You call me Bud, and that'll sound like my family. My brother's name is Dick. It seems kind of like old home week. Belmore, New York.
The bonus! You get the pride of bonus! What's $200 tonight? Well, you both come out here. Stand here beside me. Stand right over here, Dick. This is McLean. You stand there. The girls, bring out the bonus, will you, please? There we go, worth $200 tonight. Okay, it's so heavy the girls have to have this table to push it out. Thank you very much. Now, your problem is simply this. In case any of you folks want to try this at home, let me show you. It consists of one of these plastic glasses, which you can squeeze. They're that soft, with a square bottom. You put it on a tennis racket, and your problem is to get it standing upright on its little bottom right where it should be standing. In other words, you must wind up with it standing like that within the required number of seconds. Now, the reason I asked you both to come out is that we're going to give you a choice. Either one of you may try it. Or if one of you tries it for half of the time and you decide it's a little too hard, the other might have better luck, you can change horses in midstream. You can pass it over and let the other one finish out. I'll give you a choice. Now, which one of you wants to try it? You'll try it. All right, sir, take a hold of it there. With one hand, you got to hold it by the grip. Only one hand, right down there. Take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. 30 seconds for $200. Go! Take it. Your time was almost out. You might not have flipped it that last time. You wouldn't have had it. Well, $200 in cash. A check will be mailed by Sylvania to you in the next mail. And, hey, a Merry Christmas, huh?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, well, now we find out what your next problem is on the $100 clock right away.
For real?
A little bit of news I think you ought to be in on. I was talking to Dick. I said, did you watch that stunt on the show? And he said, yes, Mac. He practiced it all afternoon. And what did your wife say to you? What'd you say to him?
You'll never make it.
You said you'd never get on, didn't you? Huh? He was silly to practice. You think he's crazy now?
Oh, no.
It's all right now, isn't it? Okay, well, Mr. and Mrs. McLean, we have a little problem for both of you now. Let's see how steady your hands are and how good your eye. Come on, both over here with me, if you will. This is for the $100 clock. Now, thank you very much. Ms. McLean, I want you to notice that this is one of those grocery store things, you know, that they take the cans down off the wall. You can grab most anything. If Betty gives me that piece of paper, I can grab that. I can also let the piece of paper go. And that's all you're going to have to do. We're going to supply you with pieces of paper, and you let them go. Meantime, you, Mr. McLean, I'm going to ask you to sit, if you will, right in that square there. Just sit right down facing this wall. Sit right in the square. That's it. Now, hold this in one hand. You can grasp it if you want to, but hold it just in one hand. You can't use your other hand at all. Meantime, Ms. McLean is going to step in back of that wall and be fed pieces of paper one at a time. She can't see you, so when she reaches it out and you think it's about where she should let go, you say, let go. And she'll let a piece of paper drop. I want you to catch 3 pieces of paper without moving from that spot in that little waste paper basket. Got the idea? Take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 50 seconds to catch 3 pieces of paper. Are you ready? Go. On to the next one. You tell her when. Here comes another one, boy. Don't worry about the old ones. All right, you got one. Eat another one. Two. Got two. Come on. You got 15 seconds. Two seconds. The clock beats you, but you got $200 from us on a bonus. It does. It was floating all over the place here. All right. Well, that's just about what it amounts to, because along with the $200, you also are going to get one of Sylvania's lovely radios, which would just be a little token if you haven't been here. With $200 cash, what are you worrying about? You beat the bonus time. Okay, good enough. Well, it's been awfully nice meeting you folks, and give our best to the kids. Do we want to wait for them? Everybody, hear those sleigh bells? That means something. That's the start of our surprise for tonight. I'm going to ask Roxanne to bring back out on stage all of the contestants that played Beat the Clock tonight and that won themselves some very lovely prizes. Now, just kind of group around me here, folks, will you, if you will? That's the idea. Good enough. Now, I think we can all see. You can step sort of in here alongside me. I don't want to put my back to anybody if I can help it. And get where everybody can see you, because I'll tell you what this whole little occasion is all about. We kind of thought that this being the holiday season, with Christmas being in the air, and since Christmas, the spirit of Christmas, should be one of giving rather than receiving, we contacted the Community Service Society in one of the locales where our show is seen. And we had them select a needy family. And we're going to call this family Mr. and Mrs. Christmas. Now, while you were playing to win prizes for yourselves tonight, unknown to you, you were also winning prizes to supply the needs of this needy family, which we will call Mr. and Mrs. Christmas, and whose story I will tell you now. Mr. and Mrs. Christmas have 5 children. They have 4 girls and 1 boy. The boy is the littlest. They live in a 3.5-room walk-up apartment. Mrs. Christmas has a heart condition and so is not able to work to supplement the income. And Mr. Christmas is working at a steady job, but he makes a very small amount of money for it, and not nearly enough to meet the needs of that growing family. So tonight, you folks, in the true spirit of giving, have with your efforts, with the fun that you've had, something for this needy family, Mr. and Mrs. Christmas. Now, I can't award all these things to them in your behalf all alone, so I've asked one of Santa Claus's many helpers, will you step over here, to come out and help me, right over this way, if you will. Come on out, Santa Claus's helper, will you? There he comes. This is jolly as St. Nick himself. I'm going to ask him to go over and open up the curtains over there and show you just the start of the things that you have won for Mr. and Mrs. Christmas and their five children. Now, first, of course, for the Christmas family, here's the tree itself, which will be delivered to them from Holiday Wholesale Florists, decorated with all kinds of beautiful fireproof ornaments by Double Glow. Under the tree, something they don't have is the lovely room-sized Coventry carpet from the Looms of Mohawk. Now for Mr. Christmas, for his wardrobe, here is a suit and a winter overcoat, along with six shirts and two warm sweaters, all from Broad Street's. For Mrs. Christmas, a beautiful gray fleece winter coat and a warm winter suit made by Will Nemirov. And along with this, two wool dresses and two crepe dresses from the International Dress Company. Now, since all the Christmas family needs shoes, National rings the Christmas bells with a pair of shoes and overshoes for each member of the entire family. Now for the Christmas household. Here are two dozen sheets and pillowcases by Spring Made. And also for their beds, six wonderful warm wool blankets from Springfield Woolen Mills. For their table, from the Stahlmeyer Company, a Ferris canned ham, along with all kinds of canned meats. And from Stokely and Van Camp Foods, a two-year supply of assorted foods of all kinds. For their holiday dinner, a wonderful frozen turkey from C.A. Swanson & Son. To make Mrs. Christmas's chores around the house easier, this universal food mixer and universal Jet 99 vacuum cleaner. Now, to make their home more comfortable, here comes another of Santa's helpers with the wonderful Pullman Sleeper, a beautiful custom-style sofa by day that converts into a bed by night. And now here come Madeline and Betty to keep the Christmas children warm with the new wardrobes. Here from Scoutex Knitwear and Mary Jane Dresses are two pairs of blue jeans and two shirts for the little boy, five sweater sets and five shirts for all the children, and four dresses each for all the girls. And from Weather Winky, a snowsuit for each child. And finally, no Christmas season would be complete, especially with children, without toys for the children. So Santa told us what they wanted, and here come Santa's helpers with those toys. From the New York Kitty Fair, there are roller skates, sewing kits, doll carriages, blocks, toy cars and trucks, cuddly toys, coloring books and crayons, a blackboard, and five Christmas stockings for all the children. And Roxanne, let's have four Roxanne dolls for the four Christmas girls. And finally, for the Christmas children, these wonderful Schwinn bicycles, with all the wonderful features that make Schwinn America's favorite bicycles. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. And you folks, I'm sure, in times to come, will think back not only on the night that you appeared on Beat the Clock, but possibly of the little catch in your throat, you might think of the wonderful joy that you brought to a family who wouldn't have had this Christmas if it hadn't been for your efforts. You made it a memorable night for us, a memorable night for them, and I'm sure that you'll find in the future it's been made a very warm and memorable night for you. So God bless you all. It's been nice having you here with us. I hope you'll think on this evening as one that made your Christmas this year a lot richer than it might have been, because the spirit of Christmas, after all, is and should be one of giving and not of receiving. Good night to you. God bless you. Thanks for being with us and helping us with the Christmas night. Spirit of the holiday season, Some of you will be seeing us maybe after the holidays are over, but we'll still have the same warm feeling in our hearts for you. A wonderful year ahead, a wonderful many years ahead, and keep that feeling and that spirit of giving in your hearts forever. This is Bud Collier speaking for Sylvania, hoping that next time may be your time to beat the clock. Good night, everybody.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Cotton production, produced in association with the CBS Television Network. Rock Stands Down, a Hannah Troy original. This is Glenn Bennett reminding you to tune in every week at the same time for Beat the Clock.